Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA tournament. Today's game is between the North Carolina Tar Heels and the Iowa State Cyclones. There's a look at the starting lineup.
I tell you, Gus, the matchup at center should be a special one. These two put up some great numbers, and they will be a handful tonight.
And just before things get underway, let's look at what each of these teams is going to be paying extra attention to. The Cyclones get possession, and away we go. On the right side. Shots up.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
The Tar Heels in their four-round-one motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
Cross court. He shoots from outside. Comes up empty from deep. Out on the wing. Rejected. On the wing. Thanks for joining CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. I'm Gus Johnson alongside Bill Raftery. Got it. They work the perimeter. He goes for three. And misses. Foul on the play. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
And here's a look at the first-year player.
Being a freshman can be intimidating, but the key is to find out different ways to contribute to the team. It doesn't always have to be scoring. If we can do the little things and play strong defense, we'll be helping out his team.
Makes the foul shot. Charity strike. Nice job defensively. In the paint. Inside. Wow, what a finish on that backdoor feed, coach.
Gus, he caught the D sleeping a little bit. Nice look and such a strong finish.
Receives the pass in the paint, and he can't get the bounce. Gets the rebound. We are at the six-minute mark. Kane handles the feed. Jump shot. He can't get it to go. He gets it back. Up and in. Ha! McDonald receives the pass. Heat check time from long range, but he misses his target. Kane handles the pass. Down the lane. Finger whip. So easy. We're at the five-minute mark. McDonald receives the ball. Timeout on the floor. CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship will continue after this. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. On the right side, he shoots from the corner. No good from three-point range. They work the perimeter. Dials up a long-range shot. No, takes the board. Out on the left wing. The freshman. Didn't seem as though anything was going to stop him on that take, Coach.
Because that's a great take. Drive into ecstasy. He drove with conviction and was rewarded with the hoop.
4 minutes left on the game clock. In the paint. He missed it.
Look for the outlet.
Around the perimeter. Well, Coach, is a timeout worth coming?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there, guys. They're really out of sync.
On the left side. Call for the foul. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
Now, you always get your hand trouble.
Bill, so far this one really hasn't been close. They need to close the gap or it's going to be over by halftime.
When it comes down to the tournament, there's absolutely no room for error. One off night usually spells the end, Gus. You see it time and time again. Mid-majors who upset higher-ranked teams. It's really important to come out ready to play.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Looking for the bomb.
Oh!
3 minutes left on the game clock. On the outside. Fires.
How about that?
They would like to get it inside to the low block.
Put a little English on it.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Looking for a good shot. Off the mark. Grabs the rebound. On the wing. Picks off the lazy pass. Kane on the move. Now they work it around the perimeter. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Turns it over. Now looking to attack. It's stripped. Active hands. The Tar Heels in a hurry.
Look at that block. Terrific.
Careless mistake there. Here they go in transition. With 10 to shoot now. Can finish. We are at the 1 minute mark. Out on the right wing. Get the top of the arc. Nice look.
Bam.
They work the perimeter. First personal foul. It's an aggressive on defense here, and he winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
Here's another solid junior bill.
By the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's about leading by example and guiding the younger players on the team.
He hits it! And he's fouled. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, guys.
With the free one. He sneaks it. The charity strike. Now they work it around the perimeter. Shots up.
How about that, Gus?
Cross court with a big shot, and it's no good from downtown. Stay tuned for the road to the Final Four. Here we see how these two teams are stacking up against each other so far. Let's check in and take a look at how both sides are doing with the keys to the game. Bill, what's going through these young guys' minds now? Here they are. They've worked all season long just to get to the NCAA tournament, and we've got a half behind us and a half to go, and somebody's got to go.
You know what I think is really impressive here tonight, Gus? Is the fact that both of these clubs are focused on each possession. The level of concentration is where you'd expect it to be during the tournament.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Turns it over. Way out on the right wing. Jump shot.
Perfect.
The Tar Heels got some good ball reversal. Coach has to be happy with the offensive execution.
Some great swing passes, ball reversal, getting them the open looks. Exactly what they want right now, Gus.
On the left side. In the lane. He drains the bucket. They work it into a double team in the post. Fire! Can't put it down. Kane takes the feed. Knocked away. Great block. McDonald handles the feed. We are at the 6-minute mark. On the left side. 10 on the shot clock. Deep check time from long range. No luck from downtown. Looking for a good shot. He doesn't get the hoop. He got it up and in. Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. Outside, Jay won't go.
It's all about shot selection, Gus. It's so important to take good shots, and not necessarily the shot the defense wants you to take.
They work it around the perimeter. First team foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
With the free throw.
They can set up the press.
Good.
Makes the shot. Dump it inside. We're at the five-minute mark. Down on the low block, trying to work it inside. And he lays it up and in. They've worked the perimeter. In the lane, the junior. Cross court. Look at the crowd, Raph. Talk about home cook. The field goal was good, and he draws the foul.
What a play.
What a shot.
Looks like all they can look forward to is next season, Coach. It was a one-sided first half. The second half is shaping up to be the same.
These guys are down right now because they weren't ready to play in the first half. Now it seems as though it's over. I don't know if they can come back from this one, Gus.
Foul shot. Way out on the right wing. Foul on the play. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
And we'll go to the free throw line. Makes it. He got them both. We're at the 4 minute mark. On the wing. Dials up a long-range shot. Bang! Got it from three. On the right side. Jump shot. And he can't get the bounce. Out on the left wing. Now we've got a turtle. Now they work it around the perimeter. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Turnover, they'll go the other way.
In transition. This is where you want to be solid, Gus.
In the post. Fires. He can't get it to go.
seeing, reacting. How alert, Gus!
On the right side. Jump shot. Can't get it to go. Inside.
On the wing.
We are at the 2-minute mark. Up and in! Ha ha! On the left side. He fires away. He nails the bucket. He can't get the bucket to fall. On the left side. He lets it go. He gets that one to fall. Raph, if the butterflies aren't going right now, there's something wrong with you.
This one can go either way, Gus. Who's going to step up and make the big play? These close games are part of the reason why I got out of coaching. The tension is just too much. Unbearable. You've got to love it, Gustavo.
On the left wing. He lets it go. He misses from beyond the arc. He launches the bomb. He misses from downtown.
A little clock management now, Gus. We have to foul in order to stop the clock. Gus, I think they'll keep fouling until they're back into this game.
And the foul will stop the clock momentarily. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And yet another stoppage, and yet another foul.
Why not?
Coach, it's tough when almost everyone on the floor can knock down free throws.
As a coach, you gotta love it when your team can knock it down at such a high rate.
On the wing. He shoots from the deep corner. And he is no good from downtown. And of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Much else they can do.
At the free throw line opportunity.
Solid shooter.
Length of the floor. He shoots from downtown. He gets it to fall. On the right side. One and the bonus.
Takes the pressure off.
No doubt about it. Gets it. He dials from long distance. He can't get the hoop to fall. All right, Raph, this one's over. One team moves on, one team's going home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all of the little intangibles we consistently talk about. And that was the difference in this game.
And before we go anywhere else, let's check in and look at our players of the game, Raph.
It was great to see these two kids play well here today. These guys really competed, Gus.
That does it for us here today. Until next time, for Coach Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson. Thanks for watching College Basketball here on CBS Sports.